On The Entrepreneur, we talk to Emma Ngigi of Linic Enterprises as she tells us how cleaning can be fun. Then we talk clean and renewable energy with Tony Nyaga of Strauss Energy. In 1778, John Wesley, an Anglican theologian, recorded a very popular phrase in his sermon: cleanliness is next to godliness. By using this phrase, John Wesley was simply implying that people have a moral obligation to keep themselves and their homes clean. However, with ever-increasing busy lifestyles, more and more people are finding it hard to personally clean their homes. This has led to the rise of cleaning and hospitality companies around the world. Emma Ngigi is one such entrepreneur. A graduate of the Kenya Utalii College, Emma established Linic Enterprises in 2010 after spotting a potential gap in the cleaning and hospitality industry.
The moment I left Serena is when I went to a place where I was exposed to outsourced services, where I was the one in charge of outsourcing the service for cleaning. And that's when I discovered that it was a good thing to do. And I also didn't also like the way you outsource people and they come and give you a very shoddy job. So I decided to just come up with a company that would set the very high standards and also satisfy the clients on that side.
Emma's decision was also informed by the construction boom that Kenya was experiencing at the time. Since the mid-2000s, the housing industry has been one of Kenya's fastest growing sectors over the last decade. Returns from real estate have even outpaced equities and government securities.
I used to travel so much. I would go set standard. Wherever Serena would buy a property, I would go and open the property. And my family was still young. And I also looked at how the real estate was coming up. And I discovered that they needed someone to clean and clean better. So I decided, I think that was a thing that I saw a lot of potential in that market. And I decided to exploit it.
Armed with over 18 years' experience, Emma hoped that by establishing a cleaning and housekeeping consultancy company, she would be able to address the challenges that face the sector. Starting the company was easy, but getting it off the ground and getting her first client was going to be an uphill task.
The biggest challenge I had is to acquire clients, to convince people that you could do it for them. And also the area of funding, like where to get enough capital to start. And I later realized that it wasn't that hard to start. Actually, I didn't need so much because I thought maybe I would start with all the equipment that are required to do the housekeeping job. But I realized you could start with just one equipment that could get you more. Yeah, and you could acquire like a tender through convincing people that you could do it. And out of my experience, I was able to convince the first client.
Emma, though, had someone who believed immensely in her abilities. She is of the opinion that it is important for an entrepreneur to consult his or her family before making any life-altering decisions. Due to the uncertainties of self-employment, an entrepreneur should avoid any unnecessary pressures, especially when the business is still young.
I received the biggest support I got from my husband because he's the one who gave me that capital to start. And he had actually talked about cleaning earlier, much earlier than I thought, but it didn't make sense then when I worked for Serena, because he started talking about it like 1995. And for me, it didn't make sense. Yeah, but after a long time, it's when I discovered, yes, there is market, there is potential in that area.
Emma's six employees at the time did not have to wait for long to get their hands dirty. Soon after, Linic Enterprises landed its first major client. From then on, Emma has not looked back, and the rest is history, as they say.
There is positive response in that, because the first client we got, we've kept them to date. Because we opened the cleaning service back 2010, and the first client we got have not let us down. They keep renewing the contract and they are happy, because apart from cleaning, we also advise them a lot on what to do and how to handle their like equipment and their fixtures and their office fixtures here.
Nevertheless, the industry is littered with very many players in a small market. Competition notwithstanding, the quality and consistency of services by Linic Enterprises is what sets them apart.
The biggest challenge is where people now want to compare you. And of course, the area is also, the market is also dominated by the very big companies. But still, wherever we serve, wherever we set our feet, these people have never let us down because they have come to understand our services and they find us very professional because we train our staff on quarterly basis. Our staff are very professional on that area and they now can't compare us with that because they know there is something that have set us apart, which is our standards. And we are also very consistent on what we do and we are detailed.
While giving out excellent services might be enough to satisfy some clients, Linic Enterprises has had to go the extra mile in order to retain more clients. One of the methods that the company hopes will raise the bar is the manufacturing of their own unique cleaning products. Among this are Linco Special Multipurpose Liquid Soap, Linco Special Toilet Cleaner, and Linco Special Disinfectant.
As we grow as a company, the needs will always identify them. The needs will always come and we identify the needs that our company required, and we've done a lot of backward forward integration in trying to help this organization at least be sustainable. It's just a sustainable approach. Yeah, that's why we came up with them. Also, the market, what we would get in the market at that date we'd want to pay, we would manage, or I mean we'd afford, was not the best product that we needed, and we realized it wasn't giving us that add product that we needed. So we decided to just manufacture our own. That is now approved by the Kenya Bureau of Standards.
These products, though, are not yet available on the market. Emma explains that their products are manufactured specifically for their own use. However, she hopes to start targeting hospitals, schools, and universities. Emma, who has served in some of the leading hotels in Kenya as an executive housekeeper, believes that cleaning and hospitality industry has changed since she started Linic Enterprises.
If I compare right now, it's a growing industry. It's a place where I would ask if a person, if you are looking for a business to start by cleaning for people because it's showing a lot of, it's very promising. Now given a chance that there are very many real estate people coming up, banks are going to real estate, everyone is going to real estate. And also the companies have also decided it's no longer our job. We can get a professional do this for us while we did with our, or we handle our core business, which is easy for everyone.
Linic Enterprises currently has over 70 employees. It plans to increase this workforce by diversifying into other cleaning and hospitality related industries.
What we have done, we have a baby company also called Linex that will only deal with training of the housekeepers. It will train for hotels, it will also train for apartments because there are very many apartments serviced coming up. And it will also train for other cleaning companies that are there. And what we also want to do is we are introducing another course that is about life saving, because we discover that as you work for a hospital, you must be a person who can also save life. So our staff are going to be known for, they are not just cleaners, but they can also be used as nurse aides. So that is a new course that we want to introduce to them. And we're also coming up with that training institution for all housekeepers. We also want to make our manufacturing farm bigger by getting more people to come and work on it and package even better. And the other thing we have also done, we have also gone to a collaboration with Kenya Utalii College where they will be giving us staff. And once they get here, we will also now train them on how to become Linic staff and how to handle our clients. The other area that we haven't gone so far is the front office. The only place we had offered the front office services was the Kenya the Standard Chartered at Jiromo Road. It is the headquarters of StanChart Africa, and that's where we offered the services, the front office services. And it is one area that we are looking at, so that once we get the clients, we are able to clean for them and also man their front office and their switchboards.
In order to give back to the community, Emma Ngigi has been training and employing women from the Kibera slums. By doing this, she hopes that she will empower the women to be self-reliant.
We want to be the leaders in the market, just like any other big craning company. And we also want to, we are promising to give quite a number of Kenyans jobs. We are really working on the sustainable goals, and we want to be there like any other company. Where right now we are working with ladies from Kibera. We are getting ladies from Kibera. We bring them here, we train them on customer service, we dress them well. And when they go out there, they are able to get jobs. And we also get jobs for them. We just call them in the office, they are dropped to whichever house that need to be cleaned. Because we are saying in the next coming future, we want Rinik to be one of the market leaders that will contribute so much to this Kenyan economy.
So, what words of advice does Emma Ngigi have for would-be entrepreneurs?
I would advise them not to give up, because many times we give up even before we start. And look at something and focus. Just be focused. Pick one thing and work with that one thing. Don't pick two things at a go. You can also copy from what they are doing. Don't design something new. Just try to modify what has been there and move with that idea and grow it to what you want.